closer look. Don't know if you're seeing this, but pretty horrendous. Hoping, obviously, that I can rescue it. Pretty horrendous. And a bit of a letdown when I saw it, seeing that the tank is so nice on the outside. But we'll give it a shot. Okay, so here's the tank upside down, and also I've taken the fuel pump out mainly to see what the condition was, but also to gain access. Now let me just shine a bit of light in there and you can really get to see just how grim this is. There's some surface which is not so bad, but obviously it depends on the way the bike was leant over, and this was leant over on its side stand, so one side's going to be worse than the other. This is the worst side, and all of that back bit there is really bad, really bad. I mean, this is quite something, but I'm still convinced I can rescue this tank. So that's my mission. What I've got to do, I think it's probably going to be better to try and do it this way, I might try and do it this way at least, is plug up the normal fuel filler down at the bottom there, and then I can fill this whole tank all the way to the very top of this level with the sodium carbonate, and then we can use electrolysis to pull all the surface rust off, hopefully. So we'll have a look at how that pans out. But yeah, horrendous. The outside, beautiful. The inside is one ugly beast, to say the least. Take a look at this pump. This is how the pump came out. It looks hideous, doesn't it? Yeah, so that's what our good old fuel does to things just sat there not working. Right, so the tank cleaning process starts here. I've got 2 kilograms of sodium carbonate. Comes in a bag like this, kind of looks like good old-fashioned soap powder, really. So I'm going to dissolve 1 kilogram, half of this, into 19 litres of water in this bucket. I'm not sure how many litres I'll get in here, but I shouldn't think that is the tank capacity in that bucket. So 19 litres are going to go in there. Then I'm going to take them by jug and pour slowly into here. What I have done is put the fuel pump back on the base of this because that had a natural seal. So I'm just use that to seal it back up, and hopefully it will stay sealed, having already undone it. Then I'm going to fill it to the neck. Now, this is hopefully level or pretty level. I probably need to tilt that forward a little, but hopefully that filler neck, I will get it level to the point where I can, so that obviously there's as much sodium carbonate fluid all the way up to that filler neck to try and get the rust right off the very surface of that neck. Then I'm going to try a bit of a beast of an anode. So this is what you connect your positive to. This is going to drop into the tank like so, and then be careful that it doesn't touch any sides. Then what I will do is connect the positive terminal to the anode, so that's a positive from the battery charger to here, and then the negative will go to a clean part, or this is rusty, but a clean part of the metal to produce that current that'll flow through in the carbonate solution, sodium carbonate solution, which then should draw off the rust from the metal surface towards the anode. So we'll see how that goes. Right, so I'm using an old battery charger that I haven't used for years, actually. It's an old car battery charger. You can put it on fast charge or normal. I'm putting this on normal, so it's sort of a less amperage run through. And as you can see, you've got the negative on a clean rust-free part of the tank, and I'm using this gigantic bolt as my anode, and I can hear this bubbling. I'm pretty sure I'm still getting a charge through there. Right, this is the next morning after the first evening of electrolysis. So this is the state of the anode. So as you can see there, that's a lot of rust that's been attracted to the anode, because that's where the electrical charge is being run through, so it pulls all the rust through the solution. Now what I have done is in case you're wondering, by the way, how did I get 19 litres of fluid from there to there? Just use a good old-fashioned siphon. Don't necessarily suggest people should do it, but yeah, suck on the pipe as the fluid comes up over the bend. Once it comes up over the bend, stop sucking, and hopefully it will pull all of the fluid through the pipe. It took me a couple of times, and then it did. I didn't swallow any of this nasty stuff, and don't swallow anything at all. What I did do was just put a shirt over this bucket. So if I just show you, you can see that in that bucket is most of the water and sodium carbonate. And the reason for doing this is to let the water obviously filter through and then really show you quite how bad it is and what's been attracted from the rusty metal surface into the solution itself. But yeah, as a filter, that's some of the bigger particles that have gone through onto that shirt. And there will be a lot of loose particles in the tank that I need to flush out with some water now, and then run the electrolysis process again. Right, welcome back to Dino's Garage. This is after I've done the second dose, if you like, of electrolysis using the sodium carbonate on the fuel tank to try and remove the rust. Now I'll show the inside of the tank after just flushing it out for the second time. Let's have a look as best we can. I'll take this head torch off and try and show you this way. Now it's not perfect by a long shot, but there is visible signs of clear metal. Some of that you see down the bottom is sort of loose residue, and some of it is still sort of weather, still rusted, but most of it, I would say, most of it has been removed. Now let's show you what it looks like that came out of the tank for the last time. Now that is grim, I think you'll agree. Look at the state of that. That is nasty. So it just goes to show you really that the electrolysis broke this rust down, pulled it from all of the steel surface into the water, and then, like I say, using some nuts, which are those there, once I've flushed this out and it's dry, I'm going to use a tank sealer, which is like an epoxy resin sealer that will bind all the loose surface that you see in there, coating the rust and making it a sort of fuel proof coating over the entire inner part of that tank. So that will be sorted. So I'm confident I've sorted and rescued this tank. Welcome back to Dino's Garage for the YZF750R, and this is a continuation of the tank sealing process. So yesterday I removed all the rust, flushed it out, dried the tank completely with a hairdryer blowing air into the base section and making sure it's completely and totally dry, because the next stage is using this stuff. Now this is tank cure, it's a two-part, so the top section is the accelerator that you add to the, basically it's like an epoxy sealant, so that's the part that makes the bottom part go off. So I'm going to mix these two together, but before I do that, I'm going to seal the base where the pump normally goes into the tank, and then I'm going to put something over the top to seal the top. I'm not going to use the filler cap because the filler cap will sit inside the neck, and I actually want some of this sealant to go in and around that neck area, just to make sure that the rust area around that neck is also sealed and covered with this stuff. So basically I'm going to get on with this process, and then I'll show you after I've done it what it kind of looks like after. So you all remember from yesterday's video what it looked like inside. So I'll show you what it looks like inside in about 20-30 minutes. So the tank is finally finished. I've coated the inside of this tank now a couple of times. The first time I think I really should have heated up the tank and heated up the liquid a bit more. When I did it in an evening, and the temperature probably dropped between sort of 15 to sort of 12, 10 degrees, something like that, in that evening. Being just about get an idea. The pump, incidentally, in there, the old pump was deteriorated by that old fuel. It killed all the rubbers. I think I showed you that, absolutely destroyed the rubbers. And the pump that's in here is actually out of an FZR600. I believe that would be the fox eye, what it called, the fox eye with the twin headlights at the front. So it's an FZR600, and it's a Denso fuel pump with exactly the same model numbers stamped on it, exactly the same reference numbers. Like I say, it's an FZR600, and it's exactly the same part that it will be for an YZF750. So luckily for us, Yamaha utilised different parts, and as we know with the YZF750, there are a lot of parts that come off of the Thunder Ace 1000cc bike that you can basically put on a YZF750 as well as, so sort of check out those details. So there we have it. That is the tank sealed, new pump in, well, second hand new pump in there, and hopefully there'll be no issues with that pump. So, you know, fingers crossed when I connect up, that pump will be working fine and well and good. So that is, in effect, a tank saved. If you're wondering why that looks a bit weird on the back, I just use a cure rust, rust proofing stuff, just to coat over the inside of it. Any surface rust has all been sort of primed, painted over with that rust primer type stuff. So there we have it. That is the tank sorted. I do have a new filler cap to go in the top of that, with a key, of course. So yeah, there we go. We'll see that eventually when the bike's back together, and hopefully we'll hear her running, and the new tank is all part of the journey. Thanks for watching.